Hey Gutfeeders, welcome to this video about Celery Juice FAQ. One of the questions you asked the most in the last Celery Juice video was about allergies. Are you actually allergic to celery, or is that a detox reaction? How can you separate, and what to do if you're really allergic? This is what we're going to talk about in this video. Really, really excited here. The last FAQ celery juice video skyrocketed everything. I'm so excited. There are hundreds and hundreds of comments and likes, and you're really engaged in that. Thank you so much, Gutfeeders, for being part of this adventure. Without any further ado, let's look into what you're gonna learn in this video. Three things. We're gonna talk about different reactions to celery, how to know if you're really allergic, if it's a detox reaction, should you avoid the celery, or what should you do. The second one, allergy testing. I've had 15 years of allergy testing experience. I love to share that with you and what I learned out of that. And the third thing is alternatives if celery for you right now is not the right thing, and also some detox support if you want to start your journey with the celery juice and you have some mild reactions to it. Now guys, without any further ado, let's get going. Number one, how to know if you are really allergic, what's happening there in your body, should you avoid celery juice or should you just start with a little? The most important thing for you guys to understand, and this is also what I got in the questions from you a lot, there is a complete difference between two things. If you just bite into one little piece of celery, or you have like a drop of celery juice and your throat starts to swell, you get breathing problems, you have a severe immediate reaction to celery. This is a stop sign, an absolute warning sign, a precursor for an anaphylactic shock, and it can actually get you in the hospital, and even untreated can cause death. This is super rare, guys. The other direction, however, is a food intolerance or a diagnosed food allergy to celery. That's a completely different pair of shoes, and I really, really encourage you to keep this separate. I want you to be safe and not end up in hospital because you had celery juice. Again, that's super rare, anaphylactic shock, really rare. This one, however, there's the confusion happening. If this is your path, if you have a food intolerance or allergy to celery, you've got two choices. You either take out the celery completely for a while, or you start with a little and you see how you can tolerate that, and then you increase the doses up to 16 ounces or 400 milliliters of celery juice in the morning. Guys, if you're confused and frustrated with all the allergy testing and with the celery juice, is this a detox reaction or am I actually allergic? Should I avoid it? Should I do it anyway and just get through the discomfort? Please know that first of all, you are not alone, and it's also not your fault. I've dedicated this video to get some clarity, to help you get in touch with your gut feelings and also really support your body to heal the fastest way possible. This whole food allergy thing is really, really confusing. I've suffered from allergies for 15 years, guys. I did all of the tests. I did the alternative tests. I did the most expensive tests. I did EGE, EGG, and they showed all kinds of different stuff. I had food allergies, I had hay fever, and I also worked with clients with celery juice, without celery juice, with anaphylactic shock, without anaphylactic shock. What I'm sharing here with you is out of my experience and out of the people I worked with, and I want to give you the best chance to heal and to get clarity in what works for you. So now let's go into more depth about the whole allergy test theme. The most important thing I want you to take out of this video is that whatever test you do, whatever EGE, EGG, whatever tests you do, they are not accurate. It's not your fault. It is also not the fault of the good meaning practitioners you might have worked with already, or doctors who are dedicated to science and to help you heal. The reason why powerful healing foods like celery often show up in allergy tests is not because your body is not able to handle them, it's because of something else. And this is key to understand. I want to explain that to you very simple so you can take that away. When you drink celery juice or eat celery or any other healing food, this actually kills off pathogens. Yeah, for example, H. pylori in the case of celery juice in your stomach and in your intestinal tract. This H. pylori or another bacteria releases toxins when it dies. Your body reacts to those toxins with a histamine reaction. It creates inflammation because it wants to take care of the toxins so that they can get transported out. This is exactly when the allergy test says like, ooh, histamine reaction. This person is allergic to celery, when it's actually the opposite. Often the most healing foods are the ones that are listed on you're allergic to bananas, you're allergic to avocado, you're allergic to celery, to cucumber, whatever comes up, tomatoes, that big one. Now guys, of course I can't say to you now, just eat everything you're allergic to, you're gonna survive. I'm not gonna do that. Again, also I did before remember the anaphylactic shock, which is rare, but it exists and we gotta take care of that. And the other way, with severe food allergies or food intolerances, gonna work your way up. Baseline I want you to take away is really being very attentive and a little bit precautious about your allergy results. Whole foods, like fresh, ripe fruits, vegetables that are grown in a good way without pesticides, they are designed for your body and they help your body heal. And then how to do this, which steps, this is really a little bit like a dance with your body. It's an individual case, but don't buy into this, oh, my body is allergic to all kinds of foods, I can't eat this, I can't eat that. Allergy tests are not accurate simply because we don't really know what we're testing and we haven't really understood the intelligence of our own body and how healing foods actually impact our body. Before we go into the third part of this video, the alternatives for celery juice, where to start, and also some detox support, let's go into a little bit more depth about celery juice. If you watched any of the videos before, you know that celery juice is one of the main key helpers to cleanse your liver, to build up your HCL levels, your good stomach acid, and improve your overall digestion. What I haven't mentioned so much is that celery juice is so powerful that it can actually change the inner chemistry of your digestion because it gives your body the missing healing blocks. Yeah, these are clostrosols, they are phytochemicals which are very, very specific to celery. Digestion actually makes a whole transformation happening. It also kills off H. pylori and reduces inflammation. If you do it over a longer period of time, I recommend always to start with 1 week and do it every morning. Now, if you decide to do celery juice, that's awesome. You get thumbs up from me. I know I personally hated celery juice, especially in the morning. I wanted like a watermelon or something fruity, and then this salty thing, you know, and then cleaning the juicer, it's a lot. However, it's not enough. I'm sorry guys, it's not enough just to drink celery juice and to keep your normal diet, because that's when a whole lot of detox reaction also happen. You gotta also clean up your diet. This is key. Yeah, so low fat, low protein if you have chronic issues, especially around your gut. Not forever, but for a time while you're healing, to support your healing process. And the other thing is, during the day, you wanna eat high nutrient dense foods. Everything that is raw contains this high quality water, also high quality water filter is important. Keep your body hydrated because this will help to flush out the toxins from your body. Guys, if you're thinking now, oh God, where do I start with this? You know, clean diet, I have a full life, I have a full-time job, I have a family, or I don't have the energy to figure this out all by myself. I don't want to do this alone. You've got two options now. And you can do them both if you like. You can start right now with the 1 week gut healing challenge, which I link for you below. This is a 1 week program that you can do in your own pace, which gives you everything, meal plan, recipes, mindset work, all included. I've got a lot of good reviews on that. And the second option is you can join me for 5 days. We're going to do a detox cleanse together. Simple, without you going hungry. It's going to be fun. And it's a great way to start the new year. It's going to be a live group. The places are limited. I'll link you down below the form where you can sign up already to get notified once the enrollment starts, so you can really make sure you get your place. It's not going to be crazy healing foods, just simple whole foods. You do it in a group, you get a buddy, and we're gonna do it together. It's gonna be live calls, it's gonna be amazing. Now let's go for number three, detox support helper and alternatives if you're really allergic or you have problems just now with taking celery juice every morning. One of the best detox support helpers, guys, I talked about that a lot already, but I'm gonna give it to you again, is Hawaiian spirulina. And here's why. When you take celery juice and you have a lot of toxicity in your body, to avoid these strong detox reactions and also to help your body to deal with the toxins that are now get flushed out of the liver, out of the lining of your intestines. They get into the bloodstream, then your body needs something to transport them out of the body. And that Hawaiian spirulina is not only rich in nutrients, it contains vitamin K, vitamin B12, all kinds of phytochemicals. It also helps to bind on the toxins and gives your body a huge, huge support while you're doing the celery juice. And now here's how to do it. So you drink the celery juice and then 30 minutes, an hour after you take 3 to 4 of the tablets of spirulina. I'm going to link you my favorite product down below. If you start with this, I recommend 5 tablets per day, and then you increase after the 3rd day up to 10. Now, Hawaiian spirulina is not a supplement. This is a healing food. It's alive, it's full of nutrients. If you're high sensitive, you might also feel the quality of spirulina. It's very, very light. It gives a lot of brightness. I feel more clarity in my mind. My senses are getting wider, my heart opens. It's a really beautiful algae, and it's a great support in your healing journey. What are some alternatives to celery juice? If you're one of the people who are reacting to celery, it might be good for you to leave it out for now to calm down your digestive system. Maybe it's too strong, maybe there are too many toxins in your body. You don't have to go through all this kind of hard detox stuff. I'm not for suffering at all. One of the best ways I found for my clients that work the best is to start with 2 things. So you either can replace the celery juice one-on-one with a cucumber, so it's going to be 1 or 2 cucumbers instead of the whole bunch of celery. 16 ounces, 400, 500 milliliter is great. You can also do the same thing in the evening. So having 2 cucumber juices is even better than 1. And the second thing is aloe vera juice. This is for people who are really, really sensitive. Aloe vera is one of the most healing and hydrating things you can do for your gut. If you have a cut, for example, and you put aloe vera on, it's incredibly healing. And it's the same, you know, like the skin you see out here is a replication of how your gut looks inside. If you have any kinds of skin issues, for example, taking aloe vera juice inside will also help your skin issues. Of course, you can put it outside as well. So you cut a leaf in half, and then you scoop out the gel, and you basically just mix it with high quality water and drink that. On an empty stomach is the best. And again, you can also include the Hawaiian spirulina to help detox your body faster and to offer your body this vehicle to transport out the toxins. Guys, if you're doing this for a while, yeah, let's say a week, 2 weeks, and you're one of the people who reacted allergic to celery in the beginning, I highly encourage you to retry the celery here and there and see how your body's doing with it now. It's very, very likely that the food intolerance are gonna disappear in your healing journey. Guys, I'm gonna end this with a story. I actually had a client who had an anaphylactic shock from celery before he met me. He was really allergic, couldn't work with celery. We did the cucumber, we did aloe vera, we did all kinds of healthy cleaning foods. We helped his body detox. And 2 months later, and this was amazing, I would not have done that on purpose, but he actually went to a restaurant and he forgot to say his usual, I'm allergic to this and this and this and celery. And he found out afterwards that there was celery in the soup, which had caused him before like really severe, extreme. He had an EpiPen, constriction of the throat, medical care status. He had the celery in the soup, he didn't notice it, and there was no, I tell you, no reaction. And this is amazing. So guys, I want to give you that as an outlook. Of course, I can't promise you anything, but it's absolutely possible that your body will actually recover and you can enjoy all those bananas. You know, I had a banana allergy. I can eat 15 bananas now for breakfast without any reaction apart from happy gut feelings. Keep an open mind and also really feel into your body and feel what makes intuitively sense for you. I wish you a beautiful day. Maybe I see you on the 5-day detox. That would be awesome. Thank you for watching and thank you for commenting below. If you have any questions or any healing success, let us other gut feelers know. Bye bye.